I needed someone. That's probably why I had the mannequin, because I felt I needed people, someone, and I didn't have, I was too shy to be around real people.
When I was little, there were a lot of Billie Jeans out there. A lot of girls who used to, they used to call them groupies. In the 60s, they would hang around backstage doors, and any band that would come to town, they would have a relationship with. I had to share bedrooms with one of my brothers on the tours, and there was some action going on in my room every night. I could hear it. And I used to, my job was to play sleep, and I was told by one of my brothers, no matter what, don't get up, don't open your eyes. I go, I promise I won't. And so I would hear these girls come in, and I would hear them say, is that little Michael? And my brother would say, yeah, and they would go, oh, he's so cute, like that, and I heard everything.
So on some occasions, you're lying down pretending to be asleep,
mm-hmm.
and your brother's having sex with someone in the same room.
Mm. Mm-hmm. I think I wrote this out of experience with my brothers. Every girl claimed it that their son was related, you know, to one of my brothers.
Put him down to New York! Get out of town!
Michael's provocative flirtation undoes even the most elaborate security system. Though he dances away from such encounters, Michael is uncomfortable, he confesses, with the process of getting acquainted. The only total strangers he trusts are the ones out there, beyond the footlights.
You must have a lot of girls screaming after you.
Yeah, that's
how
what
do you do with that?
Oh, it's actually it's like a force thing, you know. We feel what they feel, mm-hmm. and you know, we throw it right back at them, mm-hmm. do our music.
Now, you're 21 years old now. Do you have any special lady of your own?
Not at the moment, not really.
Not at the moment.
No.
It's playing the field?
Mainly the fans, yeah.
Yeah.
Looking around in the audience.
I think all my success and fame, and I've wanted it. I wanted it because I wanted to be loved. I wanted to become such a wonderful performer that I would get love back.
So you thought if you became a great star, very successful, and loved by the world, your father would love you too?
Mm-hmm.
You could change him that way?
Mm-hmm. I was hoping I could. And I was hoping I could get love from other people, because I needed it real bad, you know. I needed someone. That's probably why I had the mannequin. Because I felt I needed people, someone, and I didn't have, I was too shy to be around real people. I love them. It's like real babies and kids and people. But it makes me feel like I'm in a room with people.
I get embarrassed easily, and I don't know, sometimes. I'm most comfortable on stage than any place in the world. Being around, you know, everyday people and stuff, I feel strange. I do.
Sure.
Yeah.
But tell me something. You're like 12 feet before
me. I am.
But how can you be that way when there's so many people around?
Because I don't love those people.
How's wearing you?
Not on tour. I get afraid of, well, I don't know people. I get afraid of people sometimes. I don't. It's a whole other life that I haven't really experienced that. Like friendship is a thing I'm just beginning to learn about. I was raised on stage, and that's where I'm comfortable. And everything else is like foreign to me. I'm just beginning to know and learn about people, friendship, and things like that.
When I'm not on stage, I'm not as happy, and everything seems to be foreign to me or new. And I'm just now beginning to enjoy friendship, which is new for me.
Friendship?
Mm-hmm.
With people other than in show business?
Yeah.
With ladies?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I just want to know what it's like to have a real relationship with someone
It doesn't want me for me, but I don't have to look over my shoulder all the time. Yes. I don't want to die without knowing about having a real relationship with a woman. I was involved, but we never did it. I have never had a relationship. My brothers have been married. My brothers have had girlfriends. I really haven't had that.
Women can do some things that make guys very unhappy. I've seen it with my brothers. I see my brothers crying in tears and pulling the grass out of the lawn out of frustration because of their wives.
Is there someone very important in your life at this point?
Yes.
Liberian girl.
Yeah.
Is there a Liberian girl in your life?
No, I wrote that in at my house in the game room.
Do you go out? Do you date?
Yes.
Who do you date?
Well, right now it's Brooke Shields. We try not to just be everywhere and go. It's mostly at home. She'll come over. I'll go to her house because I don't like going out in the public.
I've never asked a girl out of my life. They have to ask me.
Really?
Yes. I can't ask a girl out.
Have you ever been in love?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. With Brooke Shields?
Yes, and another girl.
And another girl? So but, what kind of woman makes you, I know in the video, wait a minute, no, in the video we're going to see later, we're premiering the world video, but you say that there's a line where you talk about being quenched. So what kind of person does that for you?
Quench my desire.
Yeah, quench my desire.
Yeah. Well, Brooke, I've always liked her.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, when I was little, I used to stay with Diana Ross, me and my brothers. We stayed with her for years. I never said this, I always had a crush on her.
You did?
Yes.
I like the way Lady Diana would make her kids wait in line. She's good.
You felt an immediate connection with her?
Yeah. I loved her very much.
Yeah, she was my type. She was my type.
I heard, too, this was another one of those rumors, that you had proposed to Elizabeth Taylor at some point.
Elizabeth Taylor is gorgeous, beautiful, and she still is today.
Yeah.
And I'm crazy about her.
Yeah, but did you propose to her?
I would like to have.
Yeah. I'm going to ask you this, and it's embarrassing for me to ask you this, but I'm going to ask you anyway. Are you a virgin?
How could you ask that question?
I just want to know. I want to know.
I'm a gentleman.
You're a gentleman.
I'm a gentleman.
So
I'm a gentleman.
So, I would interpret that to mean that means that you believe that a lady is a lady, and therefore
that's something that's private. I mean, you know, shouldn't be spoken about openly. You can call me old-fashioned if you want, but you know, to me that's very personal.
So you're not going to answer it.
I'm embarrassed.
So you're not going to answer it.
I'm a very family-orientated person because I come from a family of 10 children. So I'm very used to the family, you know, surrounding, camaraderie of just a unity. So I don't think I could live without that bond. So I would love to have a major. Actually, I told her 12. See, my aunt has 13 children. I have an uncle who has 12 children. My father had 10 children. So I love big everywhere.
Would you like to have a big family like that?
Yes.
You
very
would.
Big. Very probably big. Twice that size.
You want to have 18 kids?
Yeah. I'm serious, really.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah, well, hey, good luck to you. God bless you. 18 children. I heard.
Well, we would like to know whether or not there is a possibility that you are going to marry one day and have children.
I would feel that my life isn't complete if I do not, because I adore the family life. I adore children, and I adore that whole thing. And I would love to. That's one of my dreams, but I couldn't right now because I'm married. I am married, but to my work.
Mm-hmm.
I'm married to my music. And it has to be that closeness in order to do the kind of work that I want to do.
She promised me that before we married, that would be the first thing we would do without children. So I was brokenhearted. And I walked around all the time holding your little baby doll. I'd be crying at how badly I wanted it.
I know what it means to have to balance the demands of family and career. And let's not even talk about finding a date for myself, even though...
Don't worry about it, baby. Don't tell him, baby. Tell him, baby. Work him, baby. Work the room. Work him.
No, this... Even though Rabbi Shmuley keeps telling me that he's gonna find me the perfect woman.
What lie to him?
My response is, as long as it's not a journalist.
Yeah, that's okay.